Welcome to the fourth part of converting a Templar Wheeler project. We have already upgraded Typo3, converted the data, and now we have a ready working backend. But now let's have a look to the front end. It doesn't work because in TypoScript we find the Templar Wheeler inclusion on the page object, and this of course don't work. So we have to modify our TypoScript template. At first we edit the whole template record and we include the mask TypoScript template. It's important to include after CSS styled content or after fluid styled content. Both of them works with mask. Save and close. And now let's have a look into the setup field and search for the page part. Here it is. Here is the Templar Wheeler module, and we can still remove this and replace the 10 with temp.mask.page. You don't have to use this. You can also use the regular Typo3 fluid template, but with this one you don't have to write so much TypoScript. Let's have a look in the documentation. Extension manual and page templates. Here you have an example, and this loads this TypoScript. So we only have to set the path to the default template. This can be done with this line, or if you have more templates, with this block. So I insert this here and I set the default path, and templates are stored in file admin templates, and here is temp home, temp normal I think is the regular template. I'm not sure, so I look into the old project, the page templates. The normal page is temp normal HTML. Okay, so I can copy the path from here and set it here. And I have to do nearly the same for the other templates. We have three templates: the normal, the newsletter, and the home page. Newsletter and home. Okay, what's wrong at the moment is the ID here in the beginning, the two. Let's replace them later. This is the ID of the backend layout. The converter generates a backend layout for each Templar Wheeler page template, and they are stored here in page ID 0. And we have to move them to a regular page or storage folder. I use the clipboard so I can move, I can move them all together, and I use the old Templar Wheeler storage folder and I insert it here. Okay, we can see the start page, the home page is ID 1, the regular, the default is 2, and the newsletter is 3. So remember this. Here in our page area, home was 1, newsletter was 3, and 2 or default is our regular template. Okay, now clear the cache and have a look to the front end. Nothing is happen. Okay, let's have a look again to the path. Page 10 file C object. So let's have a look at the object browser. The page object 10. Ah, okay, I see the error. Page is page and 10 is page again and not fluid template. So I did something wrong on copying. Sorry for this. We need not this line, we need it above. Page gets temp mask page and save. Clear the cache and reload. Now we have the Templar Wheeler page template with example content, and we have to adapt this. We are on page home, so start here, and at first remove the header part because it's inserted from the page object. So I remove this, and on the bottom also body and HTML, the closing tags, and here are some TypeScript, or perhaps you have JavaScripts included, and let's include them in TypeScript. So I paste them here to have a template, and then write simply include CSS. And we have styles equals let's have a look into the file system. It's in templates styles CSS. And we have print equals and we have handy equals and paste them here. Okay, here's also a media attribute, and I'm not sure. Let's Google for TypeScript include CSS. The TypeScript reference include CSS and dot media. Okay, this is the subsetting. Simply dot media equals print. So print dot media equals print, and handy dot media equals handheld. This website was not responsive. It's an old type of CSS. Okay, now yes, let's clear the cache again and have a look to the front end. Okay, it looks better now, and the source code also have the page header, and inside the body tag is the each HTML without a second structure. Okay, now let's have a look to the old project and template wheeler. We can see the fields in this template. We have a navigation in the div SNAY inner, and it's named libnav. So we search for this tag, it's here. Inner is meaning this part inside, and we replace this with an fluid tag, an FC object for TypeScript, and the TypeScript object path equals libnav. Okay, the second one is links. It's from type content elements, it's the left column, and it's the tag I start li. Okay, remove the example content, and we also insert a fluid tag with FC object. Then we have the field right, it's the tag I start re, it's here. We also replace the content inside, and the last one is lib Fußzeile, it's the footer, the tag S Fußzeile, and it's from the type TypeScript, so we also replace the content of S Fußzeile with this tag, and we name it lib Fußzeile. Okay, navigation and footer is ready, but not the two content columns, left and right. Let's have a look to our backend layouts. We move them to this folder. It's the start page, the home page, and we see the column left links is 0 and right rechts is 1. So we set these values to our TypeScript. I name it content 0 and content 1. At the top there are images. We have to add the absolute path. It's file admin templates. So also the images are working now. Okay, save, and now we have to define libcontent 0 and libcontent 1 in our TypeScript template. So let's go back to our setup field. I scroll down to the end and I insert libcontent 0 copies styles content get, and also libcontent 1, but libcontent 1 gets a second line. It's select where equals corpus equals 1 and save. Clear the cache and reload the front end. Okay, we see the top image, the header image, because the paths are now absolute and are working. We see the navigation and it should work. And we see the two content columns and the footer, and all works fine because the TypeScript is unchanged. For example, the navigation, it was in Templar Wheeler, an NH menu directory with a lot of TypeScript, and it hasn't changed. It's simply the same TypeScript for the navigation and also for the footer. Okay, but the content elements are not working yet because the HTML is missing. So let's start with the easiest content element. It's named text. So we create the HTML file onetext.html in the folder fileadmin templates content. It's here, new HTML. Okay, we remove the basic HTML, and in the mask module you find an HTML icon, and here you have an example code with fluid tags for the output. And let's format it. Oops, the wrong key. Okay, but we have to migrate them with the Templar Wheeler's HTML. So we go back to the old project, to the content elements. We search for the text element. It takes the HTML from temp elemente. And from the tag iText, and it replaces iText inner with the content. So we open temp elemente, we copy the iText div and place it outside of our field. The if condition isn't needed. Oops, format the code and save. Okay, let's go back to the new backend, clear the cache. If I reload the mask backend module, the file is not missing anymore. And in the front end, we see all elements with type text. And this is nothing, it seems like. Let's have a look at the home page. And we have a headline. Okay, but not any text element visible. Oh, here is one. No, here. But it's empty. Okay. So let's modify the second element, Überschrift. It's meaning header. We go back, we create three Überschrift in the content folder. Create. Then we can insert the HTML. We only need the field. And we need from the old project the same content element. It's here from temp home. And it's inside of div I underscore h1. Okay, temp home. Okay, we deleted it. It was a example content. So I go back. It's here. And I go forward and insert it in our template. And insert our fluid tag inside of the h1 tag inner. Okay, that's it. We can make a line break and save. Clear the cache again and reload the front end. And now we have all headlines visible. Now reload the backend module of Mask, and also the Überschrift is working. Here is a wrong icon. We can replace it with an icon what you like, a header, perhaps an H. Save and close. Now we have a nicer icon. Okay, that's it. Now you have to do the same steps with every content element and every page template. We have only fixed the home page. Now we have the regular page and the newsletter also. See you again when you are ready.